Okay, so we spoke about now what is the thing is disciplined agile is answering with Scrum and agile is not. So now hopefully you got a preview that it's a combination of multiple things. It's little aggregation of various approaches and stitching them together so that the complex large organization can take care of it. So that's the whole things. Now, as a Scrum Master, Agile Coach, when do we propose discipline agile in the organization? So I think it's a little controversial, and the whole idea here is, see, what is, if you see that organization is not getting value by focusing on one way of working, you may want to have an approach where people have a choices of selecting different ways of working. And if the organization is ready to do that, rather than you reinvent yourself, you might want to use the discipline agile knowledge base, which could be a useful thing to do. And see, everybody forming a 100 people team or everybody forming a 9 people team might not be a case in many organizations. Everybody doing 15 minutes daily meeting may not be a suitable things there. So that's where you possibly find out, you know, how do I handle these things differently and work on that. Okay, so now who is responsible for communicating directly or indirectly, departments and layers? So this is something one has to figure out. There is no one role which is something you is responsible for complete communication, but there are roles. There are roles as you start digging into a discipline agile. There are some primary roles, there are some secondary roles, and that the way DA is open for the tools, DA is also open for the roles. So it is not like only three type of roles can exist. You can have some of the event specific roles also added into it. So I do encourage people to see the related roles so that you understand how the communication happens in this particular space. I am trying to pick up something which is relevant and So Scrum Master roles and all. So I encourage you to study the roles and responsibility of discipline agile, and that could be a future path. So I can see there are two certification specific thing, and then there is an interesting question: can we add process in the predefined process goal? I do say that yes, yeah. Maybe not very explicitly coming in the DA framework. Probably you will find something is already there, but in case there is something, why not? You know. Ultimately, process is owned by you, not by some book or framework. Yeah, so why not? Yeah, nobody's going to catch you, and you need to own the process ultimately. That's kind of a belief I want to work on, rather than just focusing on a one framework or other.